So, sometimes it's really fun to go out and just start digging. You never know what you'll find. An arrowhead, an old coin, maybe you'll even find some dinosaur bones. And I guess we're really lucky because we've found just that. And what are these called? These old dinosaur bones? That's right, we call them fossils. And they're the really old bones of dinosaurs that have been dead for a long time. And you might recognize this one. It belongs to a dinosaur that we call Velociraptor. A Velociraptor, like other dinosaurs, is really old. It lived about 200 million years ago. That's really a long time ago. Well, let's see if we can find anything else. And here we're already very lucky. We found some more dinosaur bones. This one's got legs that look kind of like Velociraptor, a tail that's pretty close, though a little skinnier. Here's its neck and head. Those look pretty similar. And then here are its arms. Which actually, these are the sort of bones you would find inside of wings, which means that this dinosaur could fly. And its name is Archaeopteryx. Archaeopteryx, a name that means ancient wing because it could fly and it's really old. In fact, 115 million years ago is when it lived. 150 million years ago. Well, let's see, I bet we can find even one more. So let's start digging, and there we go, some leg bones, and there's the other leg, there are the hips, here's the little itty bitty tail, and here's a long neck and a head, and here are those arm bones, in fact, those wing bones again. Well, what dinosaur is this? It's one called Gallus Domesticus. And you might wonder, how long ago did Gallus Domesticus live? Well, in fact, this isn't an animal that lived in the past. This is an animal that's alive today. And you might know it by its more ordinary name, which is a chicken. That's right! This thing that looks just like a dinosaur is a chicken. And it shouldn't surprise us that it looks like a dinosaur because chickens are dinosaurs. In fact, we know now that over a long period of time, starting a long time ago, animals that looked a lot like Velociraptor changed into animals that looked a lot like Archaeopteryx. And animals like Archaeopteryx changed into chickens. And that's amazing. Different animals changing over time. We should wonder, how could that happen? How did this happen? And that's our big question for today. How do living things change over time? How do living things change over time? That's a big question, and it's also a really important one. So, can we answer this question? Well, in order to answer this question, we're going to need to take a trip. And we're going to have to visit another dinosaur in the place where it lives, which is a swamp. Let me try to draw this dinosaur. And if you guess it, then shout it out. See if you can figure out what this dinosaur is from me drawing. So, this is its head. And then it's got a really long neck. There's its long neck. And then here's its back. And it's got these big, long, tough, strong legs, and then it's got a big old belly like this, and then another set of big, strong legs like pillars, like elephant legs, and then it's got a real long, thin tail. Well, what dinosaur is this? Have you guessed it? If you said Brontosaurus, then you are totally right. This is a Brontosaurus. Some people call this a Patosaurus, but Brontosaurus will serve us just fine. Let's give it a little eye, and why not? A nice little smile. So there's our Brontosaurus. And Brontosaurus lives in a place like this. It lives around swamps. So why? You might look at it and say, you know, there's something sort of odd about Brontosaurus. And that's that it has this particularly long neck. It's got this long neck. You might ask, well, why does Brontosaurus have such a long neck? I don't have a long neck. You don't have a long neck. Why does Brontosaurus have a long neck? Well, it's hard to know for sure. But one reason might be because Brontosaurus lived in a place with a lot of swamps like this. And inside the swamps were plants that Brontosaurus likes to eat. This is food for Brontosaurus. Brontosaurus was a vegetarian and ate plants. Now, if you're Brontosaurus and you want this food, you might try just walking up into the swamp. But that might be a really bad idea. You could get stuck in the swamp. A predator like T-Rex or Velociraptor could come along and eat you. And, well, you don't want that. But if you have a big long neck, you could stand on the edge of the swamp, stick your big old neck into the swamp, and eat that food without getting stuck. And that would be a really, really, really good thing. So this long neck makes it easier for Brontosaurus to stay alive. And so what we call it is an adaptation. An adaptation. And this is the first big, important word for today. So remember this word, it's really important, adaptation. An adaptation is just something, some structure or a body part or something that makes it easier for living things to survive. That makes it easier for living things to survive. So a couple more examples. You might think of the sharp teeth and claws of a lion that help it catch prey. You might think of the nice, beautiful colors of flowers that help them to attract pollinators. You might think about the thick fur of a polar bear that helps it live up where it's really, really cold. So now the question is, how do adaptations like a long neck come about? So I want you to think now how, if we're trying to figure out how adaptations come about, I want you to think about a group of dinosaurs even longer, before Brontosaurus. And some of them had long necks and others had short necks. So this is a group of dinosaurs. Some have short necks, some have long necks. Just like you and your friends, some of you are tall, some of you are short. So now the question is, who's gonna have an easier time surviving? The long neck dinosaurs that can reach into that swamp and eat that food, or the short neck dinosaurs that might get stuck and attacked by predators if they try to do that? Well, if you said the long necks are gonna survive, you're right. So the long necks are gonna survive. They have this adaptation that makes it easier for them to live. But the short necks, well, they're gonna have a hard time getting food and they might starve and they will not make it. So the short necks are going to die out. All these short necks died out. Sorry, short necks, but sometimes nature can be harsh like that. So when it comes to be springtime and the Brontosauruses are thinking about making little Brontosaurus babies, what will those babies look like? What will those little Brontosaurus babies look like? When they have Brontosaurus babies, will they have short necks or will they have long necks? Well, if you said long necks, again, I think you're right. But why would they have long necks? Well, think about it. Only the long-necked dinosaurs can have babies. The short necks have all died out, and it's pretty hard to have babies if you're dead. So the long necks all have babies, and generally the idea is that babies look like their parents. Babies look like their parents. I mean, think about it. A Chihuahua always has Chihuahua puppies. A Labrador Retriever always has Labrador Retriever puppies. You probably look like your parents, your friend probably looks like his parents, and so on. So babies look like their parents, which means if only the long necks are having babies, then what we're gonna end up with is all long-necked Brontosaurus babies. And this is actually kind of amazing, because what's just happened is we started with a mixed group, some long neck, some short neck. And because the short necks died out and the long necks survived and had babies, the next set of Brontosauruses is all going to have long necks. That's a change in a group of living things over time. A change, this is really important, a change in a group of living things over time. There's a really important word we use for this. It's maybe the most important word in all of biology, in the study of living things. A change in a group of living things over time. We call it, get ready, we call it evolution. And when it happens because some can survive, like the long necks, and have babies, and some can't, like the short necks, they don't have this adaptation of the long neck, then we call it evolution by natural selection. Evolution by natural selection. That's the big idea. Some of the members of the group have these adaptations, like long necks, they survive. Others, they don't have the adaptation, their necks are too short, their fur isn't warm enough, whatever it might be, they die out and they don't have any babies. And this is how Brontosaurus got its long neck. And if you have enough time, this type of change is even what can give you the change from Velociraptor to Archaeopteryx and Archaeopteryx to chickens. So this is it, evolution by natural selection. Some survive, they pass their adaptations on to their offspring. Others don't survive, their babies don't get anything that they had. That's evolution by natural selection. I hope that this was helpful, and I hope you had fun. Thanks for watching.